Q&A.
This is Ty, who wants to know, does God cry?
Well, he laughs. He that sitteth in the heavens shall laugh them to scorn. That I can. I don't know of any scripture that said God cries.
He says he collects our tears in a bottle. I mean, he's so aware of our crying.
Yeah, you know, but God himself crying, I don't know anything. He runs. The father ran to the prodigal son. He laughs them to scorn. He that sits in the heavens shall laugh. But does he cry?
I think the heart of God must break when...
I think so. Mm-hmm. That's deep inside.
We are his kids. I mean, wouldn't you feel wounded if your child was wounded? Of course. So I think he gives us that image of a father, so we know his heart and what he feels for us.
I think that's very well said. All right.
This is Deshay, who says, my son was 10 months old when he died. I believe we will meet in heaven, and when we do, will he be a 10-month-old child, or will he be older?
The Bible is not too explicit, but my thought is that we will grow to the age of Jesus, and that people will not be stay infants in heaven.
Sort of the peak of
but we're spirits. You know, we'll be spirits. We're not going to be whatever, but there won't be any little babies in heaven. I just don't believe that.
Do you remember the little boy? We interviewed him and his father with the Heaven Is Real book, and he said when he met these relatives that they were... I mean, he didn't say an age, but, you know, they were young. They were not... His grandfather was not old when he met him, so
that'll
interesting.
That'll be nice.
That'll be very nice. Thank you, God.
Okay. All right. Back it up a few years. All right, what?
This is Stephen, who says, my friend David was a strong Christian, and he went to Vietnam back in the 60s. He was never the same after that. Something snapped in his mind, and it was like he became a zombie. Recently, he committed suicide. Will I see him in heaven, or is suicide an unpardonable sin?
Stephen, I'm not able to answer that, because only God knows what was in somebody's heart the moment he died, and I don't know that, and I don't think any of us know it. You'd think that suicide... Well, the legal premise on suicide is that somebody's insane when they commit suicide. Mm-hmm. So if somebody's...
Well, this man was a strong Christian before he went to Vietnam.
I understand, the act of suicide, though, I'm just saying, at law, they're presumed to be crazy. And so if a person is insane, he isn't responsible for his actions.
For his behavior. Yeah.
So that, but I don't know. Mm-hmm. I mean, we don't really have too clear in the Bible about it, but I would urge against it. Mm-hmm. Because think of the chance, if you're wrong... If ending this life would put you in eternity of torment, how horrible would that act be? I mean, what an awful thing to do.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
So don't even contemplate suicide. No way.
This is Helen, who says, can you explain what Jesus meant by the poor in spirit and theirs is the kingdom of heaven?
The actual Greek is spiritual beggars. Those who... are self-satisfied, rich in spirit. They think they've got it all, you know. Mm-hmm. And the poor are those who are always seeking more of God. I'm, you know, like the publican who beat his breast, say, God have mercy to be a sinner. The people like that are going to inherit the kingdom because they come to God and they say, God, I've got to have you. Mm-hmm. I have to have you. I'm inadequate myself. I've got to have you. I can't survive without God. That's what Jesus is talking about. There's a sense of spiritual inadequacy without God. Whereas those who feel that they've got it made, like the church in Laodicea, you know, you think you're rich, you're full with goods, you know, mm-hmm. you don't recognize you're poor and miserable and blind and naked.
Yes. It's all the time we have for today, but we thank you for your questions. We love hearing from you.